the time for ethical, it's a time to talk, it's a time for discernment, it's a time for ironing out evil. But do you understand that a hurting person will hurt somebody else? Now listen to me. Jesus loves you. He can help you to forgive because marriage is two forgivers living together. In choosing your life partner, it's important that you understand that you need to focus more on the content than the container. Genesis 2:24. Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. Now, let's get to the second stage. Now that's the first three stages of bonding. What's the first one? Eye to what? Body. What's the second one? Eye to eye. What's the third one? Voice to voice or verbal communication. Now, the second stage. Immediately you start, now let's say that both of you have, you know, you've gone to the voice to voice stage of a relationship and you like each other, you like your ideas before you are compatible. Now, you are getting to the third stage, which is quite crucial. You are going to want to touch each other. That is where the problem starts. Because if you are attracted to somebody, you are going to want to touch the person. It's all part of love. But if you don't know how to control touch, you have introduced death. But there's nothing you can do about it. You are going to want to touch that man. Now, at this stage, even though the couple is getting to know each other and they are talking and they are becoming intimate, eye contact is still limited. Now, when I met my husband and we started, you know, falling in love, and then meeting each other and talking, at the early stage of our relationship, even though I liked him and I was quite comfortable with him, I was very shy with him. Men are not very shy, but women are quite emotional. And I remember the time my husband took me to, well, my intended at that time took me to eat. I can't eat. I can't even look at him, you know. I keep taking my eyes and all that. And then he would say, eat, come on, eat. And I'll be shaking, and when I get home, of course I eat very well. But with him, you know, now, remember you are still developing the relationship. What I'm saying is there's already friendship, but it's still growing. And so you are still not very free with him. He's not still very, very free with you. He's still a woman. But you will still want to touch each other at that point in time. Now, hand to hand, if I hold your hand, is a good touch. Hand to hand is good because it shows at least we're getting close. Now, let's start with hand to hand. So we move to hand to hand. Hallelujah. Hand to hand. Before you know what, well, you can give him or her a kiss on the cheek. Like hugging, like kissing. Like kissing is not mouth to mouth. Peck. Hand to hand. Alright? Now, hand to hand graduate to hand, the hugging, you know, it's hand to body now. Well, it's hugging. Then you graduate to mouth to cheek. Process of love, falling in love. Okay? Now, some light hugging and kissing may take place during the next stages. But it should be light conventional contact only. Light conventional contact only. Prolonged periods of face-to-face embracing or deep kissing will rush the bonding process and awaken sexual responses ahead of schedule. You see, if you go and awake star drive, you want to introduce problems. And so you have to make sure. Now, the Bible says, let's go to 2 Timothy 2:22. Flee also youthful lust, but follow righteousness, faith, charity, peace, with them that call on the Lord out of a pure heart. Amplified says, shun youthful lust, and flee from them, and aim at and pursue righteousness, all that is virtuous and good. Remember, he that finds a wife finds what? If you don't pursue what is good, you are not going to find a good thing at the end of the day. If you are waking the sexual drive of your good thing, and your good thing starts to sleep with you, the good thing becomes a bad thing. Do you get the point? Hallelujah. So follow all that is righteous and virtuous and good, right living, pursue righteousness, all that is virtuous and good, right living, and conformity to the will of God, in thought, in word, and deed. Alright? And aim at and pursue faith, love, and peace, harmony, and concord with others, in fellowship with all Christians who call upon the Lord out of a pure heart. If you want to have a good relationship, you have to do the right things. If you don't do the right things, run away from what is bad and what is evil, because it will destroy your love and the process of falling in love. Let's go on. Now, so you don't want to, you know, allow the sexual drive to move you ahead to the next, to the maybe seventh stage. You want to go gradually. Now, real and genuine communication develops at this stage. Personal disclosures are made and elaborated upon. The topics for discussions are endless, but basic issues of life have been discussed and evaluated. Many personal secrets are shared, and a couple really gets to know each other intimately. Now, when you talk about knowing somebody intimately, it's not sleeping with each other. It's getting to know the person through communication and asking the right questions. You need to be intimately, bonded, all right, to actually fall in love. But intimate bonding is not sex. It's actually discussion and getting to know the person. Somebody said, see somebody as a well of information. The more you can draw information out of the person, the more you get to bond with that person. Bonding has to do with communication and compatibility. Praise the Lord. It's time to talk about your life goals and your personal beliefs so you can blend well. Do you bring out the best in each other? Do you motivate each other to better and higher challenges and accomplishments? Do you know your partner's expectations of you for the future? Now you're getting to a point where you're already going now. You are cutting. You like each other. You feel you're compatible. Now you're touching, hand to hand. You're hugging. You know you're growing gradually into like a peck on the cheek. But meanwhile, you are getting to know each other and you're asking yourself, am I bringing out the best in this person? Is this person bringing out the best in me? Are we motivating each other to better and higher challenges and accomplishments? Do I know this person's expectations of me and what he wants of me for the future? Can I fulfill him? Can she fulfill me? Will my partner allow me to develop my talent and be myself? Am I myself with this person? Will he allow me to develop my talent? These and many other questions.